Normalcy returning to Ukraine following Russia's recent attack on the country's power grid, which caused widespread blackouts last week. Ukraine's national power supply company says 80% of electricity needs nationwide have been restored. Grid operators are still imposing restrictions as a result of the 20% deficit. But in the capital, Kyiv, most residents are no longer subject to the rotating blackouts. Officials say power, water, heat, internet, and network coverage have almost been completely restored as crews enter the final stage of repair work.
North Korean leader Kim Jong-un says his country aims to be the world's most powerful nuclear force as he celebrates the recent test launch of its newest intercontinental ballistic missile. At a ceremony held on Sunday, Kim handed promotions to more than 100 officials and scientists for their work on the Hwasong-17, which he hailed as the world's strongest strategic weapon. Dubbed the Monster Missile, the Hwasong-17 is believed capable of reaching the U.S. mainland. The November 18 test was the latest in a record-breaking blitz of missile launches by Pyongyang. Analysts warn this could culminate in a seventh nuclear test. North Korea last tested an atomic device in 2017. A former military intelligence officer concerned over further heightening tensions in the South China Sea should plans for more American facilities inside the Philippine military camps push through. Retired Brigadier General Victor Corpus, the former head of the Armed Forces of the Philippines' intelligence service, says China will consider the EDCA sites as part of the forward-basing strategy of the U.S. to position its forces and weapons in the region.
Tayo may ipit sa gitna, that we will become the battleground and the war can be nuclear in nature. We will become the battlefield, like what they are doing now in Ukraine. Sino nagkakamatayan sa Ukraine? Yung mga Ukrainians, hindi mga Amerikano. Do our leaders want that to happen to us? Make us another Ukraine?
The U.S. Armed Forces already has 5 facilities in Palawan, Pampanga, Nueva Ecija, Cebu, and Cagayan de Oro City. 5 more are in the pipeline with construction set to begin next year, subject to final approval from the AFP and Defense Department. Officials have repeatedly insisted the facilities being built are not American bases.
We're not building bases. We're not allowed to. The Constitution specifically states that foreign military bases is not allowed in the Philippines. What we have are EDCA sites. This is Enhanced Defense Cooperation sites that we use for training facilities, warehouses.
In other news, former Justice Secretary and now Solicitor General Bernardo Guevara believes a total overhaul is needed at the Bureau of Corrections. Guevara says the corruption within the Bureau can only be solved if the Justice Department is given full control over it. Guevara is urging Congress to look into this, saying the current setup where the DOJ only has a supervisory role at the Bureau is no longer enough. The overcrowding in the Philippine jails has also been cited as the reason why crimes and corruption thrive. Bureau officer in charge, Gregorio Patapang Jr., says they are addressing this issue by speeding up the release of prisoners who are already eligible for parole.
Yung 70 years old kasi may meron daw yan na executive order na pinirma ni President Gloria, something of the former president. Meron daw yun na pwedeng 70 years old na parolo executive clemency. Pero titignan pa natin. Paano? Dumadaan po yan sa proseso, hindi naman sila basta-basta ma-release kung di naayos yung kanilang mga documents na talagang they are due for release o na-serve na nila yung kanilang sentence.